Dear students, welcome to the online classes of chemistry. So today we'll discuss about the organic chemistry. It is the third branch of chemistry. So we already completed inorganic few topics and physical chemistry few topics. And now the organic chemistry. So here in organic chemistry, you have to study two important topics. One is that is the basic principles and its uses are the basic principles and techniques. And second topic is hydrocarbon. So here it carries near about 15 marks. Look here, students. Number one, basic principles and techniques. And second one is hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons, and here both the chapter carries near about 15 marks question, and out of 15 marks you have to solve only 10 marks. But remember students, next year you have complete organic chemistry book. It carries near about 44 marks, highest marks in PUC second year. So first year you have to learn only the basic things. You have to learn only the basic things. What are the basic things? So here these two chapters are very important. So therefore, first let us see that is what is organic chemistry. First that is question. So it is, what is organic chemistry? Look here. Look here, students. So organic chemistry, it is a branch of chemistry which deals with the study of only carbon compounds. You know already, because at the beginning only we discussed. So here organic chemistry, it is a branch of chemistry which deals with the study of only carbon compounds or compounds of carbon. Carbon compounds or compounds of carbon. So it is called as organic chemistry. And here in this organic chemistry, we have to study the first topic, basic principles, some basic principles and techniques. And remember students, in this topic, so the two units are deleted. The quantitative analysis and qualitative analysis, it is one unit, it is deleted from the syllabus this year only. The quantitative analysis and qualitative analysis and the purification of organic compound, these two units are deleted. So let us see the first, that is organic topic, that is basic principles and techniques. Basic principles and techniques. Some basic principles and techniques. Look here students, here first we have to study that is what is organic compound. Just that is, it is a general introduction. What is organic compound? What are the organic compounds? So organic compounds plays a very important role to sustain the life on earth. To sustain life on earth, these include the complex molecules like genetic information, which is nothing but deoxyribonucleic acid DNA and proteins, and these constitutes an essential compounds of our blood, muscle and skin. So it plays very important role in a living organism. It plays very important role in living organism. That is, organic compounds, number one, organic compounds are very important. Very important to sustain life on earth. Look here, to sustain life on earth, because it is about living organisms, to sustain life on earth, these includes complex molecules like genetic informations, genetic informations bearing deoxy ribo nucleic acids bearing. Look here students, these includes complex molecules like genetic informations, which use genetic information transformations, genetic informations bearing deoxyribonucleic acid and proteins which constitute the essential compounds of our blood, muscle and skin. So it covers totally all, whatever the living organism, whatever the genetic informations, DNA, RNA, muscles, blood, all those, that is which changes takes place by only organic compounds. So it is about living organisms. Then what happens in case of non-living organisms? Look here. So organic compounds, second one, organic compound also appears, or organic compounds appear in molecule materials, that is the molecules like materials, that is nothing but so clothing, which we wear the cloth, it also contains organic compound. And then the medicines which we are taking, it contains organic compound. Dyes which we are using, drugs, and the most important one is polymer. So polymers, that is, it plays very important role in our day-to-day life, because the almost all things which we are using are made by polymers. So here organic compounds in non-living organisms, so organic compounds appear in materials like clothing. Now haaktakkanta battegalalli organic compound ada, terlin organic compound ada, nylon organic compound ada, polyester organic compound ada. So clothing, polymers, now use maadtakkanta plastic, amele now use maadtak maneyalli use maadtakkanta vastugalu, kurchi, table, ellavu enadala polymers inda maadalpattade. Polymers, fuel, now use maadtakkanta indana, it contains organic compound. So fuels, dyes, drugs, aushadagalu, vannagalu, drugs and medicines. So all these contains the organic compound. So living, and then also in materials also you will get organic compound. So students, here remember, so organic compound is about, organic chemistry is about 200 years old. In 1780, so many chemists worked to separate so work to separate the organic compounds which are obtained from plants and animals. So you can obtain so many that is organic compound from plants, and we can obtain so many compound from animals. And even they try to separate the inorganic compound. Inorganic compounds are also from the mineral sources. So mineral sources in the inorganic compound galanna separate madidru. Amele organic matu inorganic compound kodu enadalla plant inda source inda matu animal source inda enadalla separate madkondru. So idu 1780 olage enadalla attu. Organic chemistry enadalla baala old illa, only 200 year old. So remember here, look here, third point, organic chemistry is only about 200 year old. Idu 200 varshadashtu halidada. So organic chemistry is about 200 year old. So in 1780, so here the chemist begins, the chemist or scientist, chemist begins to separate organic compounds, to separate organic compounds prepared from or obtained from, begin to separate or distinguish. You may say distinguish. Chemist begins to distinguish or separate, distinguish the organic compounds which are obtained from animal source, or that is separate organic compounds which are obtained, which are obtained from animal source and plant source. So remember students, so they distinguished between the organic compounds which are obtained from animal source and plants. So you will get so many organic compound from animal sources, and you will get so many organic compound from plant sources. And even so, they separated the inorganic compound, and even they separated inorganic compounds from mineral sources. But here in 1850, Berzelius, a Swedish chemist, proposed that the vital force is responsible for the formation of organic compound. So organic compound we cannot prepare in the laboratory. There is a vital force behind the organic compound. Idukon daiva shakti ada. Ee daiva shakti idrashte organic compound tayar aagta anti kondi anadalla. 1815 olaga Berzelius helbitta. So in 1815, fourth one, in 1815 Berzelius, a Swedish, he is a Swedish chemist proposed that a vital force means God gift, or a shakti ant kartinu, it mysterious energy. So it is a vital force is responsible for the formation of organic compounds, for the formation of organic compounds. So he explained that there is a vital force, a power. So by only the organic compounds are formed. So therefore, so scientist that is not worked on organic chemistry at that time. And in 1828, when a German chemist, F. Holler, so he accidentally prepared the first organic compound urea by heating ammonium cyanate. So then all the scientists began to work on the organic chemistry, on the organic compound. So therefore, here near about in the year 1850, the vital force theory disapproved. So vital force annode eno ond shakti adu ant helidaralla adin 1850 olage enadalla so hogi bidutadu ammele ella scientists galu laboratory olage enadalla organic compound mele work madlikattru. So Hanel antakanta scientist enadalla so it is 1825 olage so ethyl alcohol kandidda ethyl alcohol prepare madida and then Kolbe's antakanta scientist 1845 olage acetic acid anna prepare madida. And then 1856 olige enadala so Berthelet antakanta scientist methane anna prepare madida. So like this that is they worked. So here Berzelius in 1815, Berzelius, a Swedish chemist, proposed that the vital force is responsible for the formation of organic compound. Organic compound cannot be prepared, he explained. But in 1828 this theory was disapproved, this theory was rejected, completely rejected. Look here how it is rejected. Look here students, in 1828 a German chemist F. Holler accidentally prepared, not by incidentally, so he prepared that compound accidentally in 1828. A German chemist F. Holler accidentally prepared the first organic compound. Remember, it is the first organic compound urea by heating ammonium cyanate. Look here students, by heating ammonium cyanate he prepared this compound. It is the first organic compound. And after this the scientists they thought that we can prepare the organic compound easily in the laboratory, and therefore the vital force theory was disapproved, rejected. So here ammonium cyanate NH4CNO, when it is heated it gives NH2CO, NH2, it is called as urea. So it is the first organic compound, and here it is the first organic compound urea. And after this there are so many scientists worked on it, so alcohol can be prepared. Then after that ethyl alcohol prepared by Hanel, ethyl alcohol prepared by Hanel in 1828. So second one, acetic acid was prepared by Kolbe 1845. Like this, that is this methane prepared by Bartlett in 1856, like this. And here, remember, in that is near about in the year 1850, or that is by the year 1850, by the year 1850, the vital force theory the vital force theory was disapproved or rejected, and the scientist began to work on the organic compound. So from this, that is, the scientist began to work on the organic compound. So it is the introduction regarding this organic compound. Remember, student, it is the complete introduction regarding this organic compound. So that is how the organic compounds are obtained in, that is, a general. So how they can be prepared, it is the history. Now let us see the first, that is, unit, tetravalency of carbon. It is from the syllabus, begins from here. Tetravalency of carbon, it is nothing but shape of carbon compounds or shape of organic compounds. Look here, students. Look here, first one, tetravalency of carbon. You know it already, you studied in the chemical bonding, tetravalence of carbon. So here we have to study shapes of organic compounds. In this shapes of organic compounds, we have to study here the shape of carbon compounds. The shape of carbon compounds. Look here, students. So here, tetravalence of carbon, unite. You was already studied in chemical bonding. And you know, you are also studied in your lower standard, that is 9th and 10th. Carbon has 4 valence electrons. And here I will write carbon, you know it, its atomic number 6. So carbon, atomic number 6, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So 1s2, 2s2, and it is 2p2. Look here, students. It is the electronic configuration, and this electronic configuration takes place in the ground state. Look here, it is ground state. So what happens in case of excited state? So in case of excited state, one electron from the 2s orbital jumps to the 2p orbital, vacant 2p orbital. One electron, 2s in the 2p ke jump aagtade. So then here it forms, so look here, I will write here 1s2, 2s1, 2p3. So 1s2, 2s1, and it is 2p3. Look here. 4 valence electrons. Look here, students. It has 4 valence electrons. It is called as tetravalence of carbon. It has 4 valence electrons. It takes place in the excited state. It takes place in the excited state. But in the ground state, it remains as 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. But in the excited state, one electron from the 2s orbital jumps to the vacant 2p orbital, and its valence electron becomes 4. It has 4 valence electrons, and it is called as tetravalence. And remember, in the excited state, carbon undergoes hybridization. It undergoes a hybridization forming, look here, in the excited state carbon undergoes hybridization forming sp3 sp2 and sp hybridization. Look here students, in the excited state carbon undergoes hybridization forming sp3 sp2 and sp hybridization. So it was also you learned in chemical bonding. Once again I will remind this. So here what is sp3 sp2 and sp? Here sp3 means 1s orbital hybridizes or mixes with a 3p orbital. It is called as sp3 hybridization. And what is sp2? 1s orbital mixes or hybrid means mix up with the 2p orbital forming, that is sp2 hybrid orbitals. And what is sp hybridization? 1s orbital mixes or combines with 1p orbital forming a linear structure of sp hybridization. And here I will show that is in brief. Look here, compound I will write here, and then I will write here this compound, and then type of hybridization. Type of hybridization. Look here, remember it is very important from the view of coaching part. And from this topic, remember student, from this topic we are going to start the coaching part, that is CET NEET, and also that is after this, that is you will also get GE mains. So from this topic organic chemistry we are going to start the coaching part. So here compound, type of hybridization, bond length, bond angle. Look here, bond length, bond angle, and shape and percentage of S and P characters. S and P characters, remember. So here the first compound is a methane, CH4. It is called as methane, and you know it, this in this methane the hybridization is sp3 hybridization takes place. Here means 1s orbital mixes with 3p orbital forming a tetrahedral shape, sp3. And remember here the bond length, in case of not only methane, ethane, propane, like the single, that is single bond molecules, so the carbon bond length is, the carbon bond length is, it is near about 154 picometer. So it is important from the point of coaching, that is the NEET and CET. So remember, carbon bond length, carbon bond length is 154 picometer, and bond angle is 109 degree 28 minutes, or in some book it is given as 109 degree 5 minutes. So it is 109 degree 28 minutes. Shape, tetrahedral shape is a tetrahedral. Remember, it is tetrahedral shape, it has a tetrahedral shape. And what is the percentage of S and P character? Percentage is very simple, sp3 means it is, the percentage is calculated for 100 means S has percentage. Remember student, S and P, S has 25% and P has 75%. Now it is very simple. SP3. So percentage is calculated for 100. Means SP3 means 4. Yeah, 1S and 3P. 1S and 3P means 4. Divided by 4 means, so S is 25% and P is 75%. So very important from the view of coaching part. Remember this. And then here you may write methane, or you may also write that is ethane, C2S6. Because carbon-carbon single bond length is longest or highest, that is 154 picometer. Then the second example, ethene, C2H4. Ethene, it has sp2 hybridization. The carbon-carbon double bond length is 134 picometer. Remember, it is 134 picometer. And this bond angle, so 120 degree, bond angle is 120 degree, or in few book it is 121 degree, like this 121.6 degree, like this. It is normally in general 120 degree. And here it is trigonal planar, it is a trigonal planar. Look here, here it is sp2. SP2 means divided by 100. So 100 means here S, percentage of S is equal to 33% and percentage of P is equal to 67%. SP3. So then next one, that is after ethene, so you have that is C2H2 ethyne YNE, triple bond compound. It is SP hybridization, mixing up of only one S orbital and one P orbital gives a linear straight structure. Look here students, carbon-carbon triple bond length is, so here remember this, the carbon-carbon single bond, here that is a triple bond. Triple bond is very short, and here it is 120 picometer, and bond angle is 180 degree, and here it is linear, or it is also called as cylindrical shape. Remember this one, cylindrical shape. I will show the shape. And percentage of S is equal to 50%, P is equal to 50%. Look here, S is also 50% and P is also 50%. The highest percentage, here the lowest percentage of S character, it plays very important role. Lowest percentage, and then that is highest, and it is highest. So ethyne, the triple bond compounds are having highest percentage of S character, and hence these are electronegative. So here I will explain here. Remember once again, it is sp3 carbon bond, single bond, carbon-carbon single bond length is 154 picometer, not in methane, in case of ethane and other higher long chains. And carbon-carbon double bond 134 picometer, carbon-carbon triple bond 120 picometer, and bond angle is 109 degree, 120 or 121 degree, and 180 degree, tetrahedral, trigonal planar, linear, and percentage. So here, let us see that is the structure of this ethyne or acetylene. Ethyne is also called as acetylene. Look here, ethyne or acetylene. Look here students, it is formula is C2H2, and its shape, look here, see, 1 sigma bond, 2 pi bond, and here it is also sigma bond, it is also sigma bond, and here it has a cylindrical shape. It has a cylindrical shape, or it is also called as linear. Idakku now linear antru karithivi, atha cylindrical shape antru karithivi. So it is about this. Now let us see what is the characteristic features of SP, SP2 and SP3. So what is the percentage of S character? It plays very important role in the view of this coaching part. Thank you. Look at students. Note. Number one. Note number one. Remember. The sp hybrid orbital. Look here. The sp hybrid orbital has more s character. The sp hybrid orbital has more s character. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಮೋರ್ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಅದ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಟು ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎ ಶಾರ್ಟರ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಶಾರ್ಟರ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ದ ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಷ್ಟದ 50% ಅದ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಇದರ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಮೋರ್ ಅದ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸರ್ ಟು ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ಗೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಭಾಳ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಕ್ಲೋಸರ್ ಟು ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಶಾರ್ಟರ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ that is 120 picometer here 120 picometer stronger and shorter bond so then second one as the s character as the s character decreases look here students very important point as the s character decreases means sp3 sp3 has only 25% sp2 has 33% and sp has 50% as the s character decreases the bond length increases as the bond length increases the bond enthalpy decreases and bond angle also decreases bond angle decrease aagtade amele enandra bond enthalpy kuda decrease aagtade bond length jaasti aatappa andre easy aagi break maadabodu theeyitu as the s character decreases the bond length increases bond length enadala increase aagkot hogtade so s character decreases andre methane ethane olage bandu alli so the bond length increases increases the bond enthalpy decreases and bond angle also ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ನೋಡ್ರಲ್ಲ ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ 180 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಅದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ಟೂ ಒಳಗೆ ಏನದಲ್ಲ 120 ಅದ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ತ್ರೀ ಒಳಗೆ 108 ಅದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ದ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ದ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎಂಥಲ್ಪಿ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಎರಡೂ ಇದಾಗ್ತದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತೀತು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಒನ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಒನ್ here so it is very important as the s character increases athwa the greater the s character the greater the s character in the hybrid orbitals in the hybrid orbitals greater will be the electronegativity ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿತ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ ಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ ಯಾವುದರಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ಅದ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಪಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ಅದ ಸೊ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋನೆಗೆಟಿವಿಟಿ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹೈಬ್ರಿಡ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋನೆಗೆಟಿವಿಟಿ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋನೆಗೆಟಿವಿಟಿ ಸೊ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋನೆಗೆಟಿವಿಟಿ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಏನದಲ್ಲ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಕೋತ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋನೆಗೆಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಯಾವುದದ ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದೆನ್ ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ಟು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದೆನ್ ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ತ್ರೀ ಸೊ ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಸೊ ಲುಕ್ ಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ the sp that is the percentage of s character so these are all that is important from the coaching part That is, they may ask in CET as well as in a NEET also. Then, now let us see some characteristic features of a pi bond. What are the important characteristics of a pi bond? Look here. So what is pi bond? You know it. When two half-filled atomic orbital overlap sideways, they form pi bond. And when two half-filled atomic orbital overlap head-to-head or end-to-end, they form sigma bond. And here, so it is, what is the importance here? Remember, in pi bond formation, the parallel orientation of two p orbital takes place. And these two parallel orientation overlap sideways by the adjacent atoms. By the adjacent atoms, then only the pi bond is formed. I will show the structure also. Remember here, in a pi bond formation, here in pi bond formation, parallel orientation takes place. So look here, parallel orientation of two p orbitals. Which are adjacent. So of two p orbitals takes place. And these two are adjacent to each other. You are to baju baju urtav p orbitals. P orbital takes place of two adjacent atoms, where the sideways overlapping takes place. Illi sideways overlapping aagtade, sideways overlapping takes place, and the electron cloud or the electron charge cloud of pi bond is always above the plane and below the plane. Remember this here. And here the bond rotation is restricted. Bond rotation enadala agudalilla, double bond mattu multiple bond dalli enadala bond restrictions agudalla. And then here, that is, pi bond formation takes place. Only in case of multiple bonds. Multiple bonds alli ashte aagtade, double bond matte triple bond alli. Nodri one diagrammatic representation torustene. Look here, in ethene, number 1, in ethene hang aagtade, C double bond H, idu H, idu H, idu H, one sigma bond, idu pi bond. Illi idu sigma, idu sigma, idu sigma, idu sigma. So idu structure hang aagtade. So its structure is like this. Look here, either sigma bond and then hydrogen hydrogen sigma, sigma, ill hydrogen, ill hydrogen, it is sigma, and then the sideways overlapping takes place here. Look here, it is pi bond. இது பை பாண்ட். இதுக்கு என்ன தினம், பேரலல் ஓரியன்டேஷன், பேரலல் ஓரியன்டேஷன் ஆஃப் டூ எஜசன்ட் ஆட்டம்ஸ் வேர் த பி ஆர்பிட்டல் ஓவர்லேப் சைட்வேஸ், சைட்வேஸ் ஆக ஓவர்லேப் அது வீட்டு அது. ஸோ இட் இஸ் ஈத்தீன் அண்ட் த ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் ஆஃப் இதைன், இதைன் லுக் ஹியர் ட்ரிபிள் பாண்ட், ஒன் சிக்மா பாண்ட், ಆಮೇಲೆ ದೆನ್ ಎರಡು ಪೈ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಅದ, ಒಂದು ಸಿಗ್ಮಾ ಬಾಂಡ್, ಎರಡು ಪೈ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಅದ, ಇಥೈನ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸಿಗ್ಮಾ ಬಾಂಡ್. Pi bond 1 and pi bond 2. Look here, it is a structure. So therefore here it is about this introduction regarding this characteristic feature of pi bonds. Look here students, it is about characteristic features. And now, so in our next class, we will discuss the structural representation. So how the organic compounds are represented. So we will study this in our next class. So thank you.